Hi everyone, it's Nicole Rogerson from Autism Awareness. I know there's an awful lot of information out there at the moment around COVID-19, and I thought it would be a really good idea for us to have a conversation about it in an autism context. So that's why I've asked Dr. James Best, who's a longtime contributor and autism dad, to come in and have a quick chat with us today about how COVID-19 is affecting all of our families. So thank you, James, for agreeing to do this.
No problem, Nicole.
So there's an enormous amount of anxiety in amongst the community generally anyway about this situation. For a lot of our families, I know that's ramped up to a whole new level. What is it the best, clearest information you think that is important for our families to understand?
Well, I think, yes, you're right. There is an enormous amount of anxiety out there right across the community, and understandably so. It's a very serious situation. In our community, in our children on the spectrum, there's going to be increased anxiety. They're already prone to anxiety to start with, and of course in this situation even more so. What needs to be done is to make sure that you go to the right information sources. There's a lot of misinformation. There's a lot of anxiety about things that shouldn't be causing anxiety. The toilet paper issue for starters. But there are some issues that which we all should be worried about. The main issue, of course, is people who are vulnerable, the elderly, and people with other medical problems that put them at risk. For most people, even if you get coronavirus, the risk of getting complications is very low if you're not in those groups. It's not zero, but it is very low. And I think that's a very important message to get across to our children, that they're not at particular, they're only at a very low risk of anything serious happening.
What happens with kids with communication issues? Because for a lot of our kids, they're not going to understand this.
Exactly. And you can only do what you can do in terms of trying to get these messages across. And I think you need to take the pressure off yourself. If you can't effectively get these messages across, well, then you can only do what you can do. But we need to try. As a community, this is a public health message. We need to get that rate of transmission down low enough that our health system doesn't become overwhelmed. And so if your child doesn't understand that they're not meant to be touching their face, that they need to wash their hands, that they need to be careful about getting close to people, particularly within that 1.5 metre radius, then if they don't understand, they don't understand. But you can try and communicate the message as best you can, including using things like visuals, but also to remain calm. You need to model calmness to them.
This is really hard, right? But I'm thinking you could also use some behavioural strategies like star charts and for how many times you wash your hands a day and some rewards for washing hands. And
Absolutely. It is harder and it will vary from situation to situation as to whether you're able to get these messages across, to get these changes in behaviours across. But you can only do what you can do.
Well, Dr. Best, thanks very much for jumping on today and talking to us about it. You gave everybody some really good advice to try and stay calm ourselves as parents so
yes.
We're not necessarily projecting onto our kids who may not always understand the context of it all.
Absolutely. Thanks, Nicole.
Thanks, James.